Which one do you want? The database?
I want the database.
I sort of thought of it as a note as well as the fact that you thought it was also a note.
Do me a favor, go to the table this time. Okay.
Right.
So, some of this stuff is basically. I'm really hoping you have all that.
Yeah.
If not, we'll do it again.
No, I got it.
Okay. Okay. So, under these resources provided,
yeah.
We're gonna see, we have SBDC.
Yep.
I have financing information.
You don't have to talk about that. No, Sarah, is that what you're talking about?
That would, that, I mean, financing information is the 500.
Is what they want. Okay.
And then what else was on, can you go back to the schematic, please?
Resources. These are the resources.
Right.
And this is all, yeah, that's a question, is it, are those all the resources that you will ever have in the future? You're talking about this in a drop down.
Like, hope to God.
There it is. So,
And somehow.
That's why I have it as kind of like a personal award.
Right.
Because.
Well, except that.
Gave them something out of the ordinary, like.
We go back to.
We gave them a full course for that.
We are not putting it.
Right, well, because then some of the other things
relates
to the company, so site selection, PR networking, project facilitation, event engagement, but event engagement, oh, this is under the business side, not, you know, this is something up. Event engagement would be if I like emerging leaders with this.
You know, just for what you're talking about, if there was ever a chance that it could increase, you know, there's something that's totally not thought of. What I'm asking, so if it's wrong, okay. Would something like that pay to have like a category in there that would say like miscellaneous? And that you would add another field in there that said notes. So
yes.
That if it was miscellaneous, you'd be able to explain it in there.
Yes, that would be fantastic.
That way, that would what I'm saying is that would not only plan for today, but ideally for tomorrow. You can still go back in and alter the database.
And it just is so annoying to have, but I have to have something. I have to have at least a couple of standards, right?
What you don't want to see happen, though, is over time, that you're not using any of those, that you're using miscellaneous.
Right.
And that's the thing that just keeps going. You know what I'm saying? But right now it sounds like you can't foresee that. That doesn't mean that it won't happen, but you don't see it. That's what I'm hearing, that you don't see it happening right now.
You know,
oops, sorry.
Could you do me a favor and go back to this has been a key component that I think that I'm just now catching on to in my year and a half of economic development. Capital investment in jobs. Did what I do here increase one of these two things? It's the correlation. Which says to me that this is something that I'm going to have to look at a little bit more deeply and figure out what this looks like. So, So under the impact, so this is what they received, right? So they received angel funding, but it still comes down to dollars. They received private capital, but that still comes down to dollars. Open a new facility, that comes down to dollars plus jobs. Received local and state incentives, dollars plus jobs.
Are you...
I'm just having a moment here. Expanded facility, opening, well, expanded facility, money plus jobs. Purchase new facility, open new facility, it's the same thing. I would just say new facility. Money and jobs, money and jobs, money and jobs. Urban company has to come back to every conclusion of the book.
But are you capturing that in here?
We're not, and that's what I'm all of a sudden looking at.
Because what I just heard her say was, that's her job. That's how she's graded. Yet there's no way, based on the criteria that we currently have, that it she can be graded.
Well, and so here's the funny thing. Right now, currently, our entire organization is not looking at the normal way that economic development is looked at. And I realized that this morning while I was writing something. And I was like, wait a minute. Economic development equals capital investment and it involves jobs. Those two things is always forefront. If I'm working on a project, it better end with capital investment or it better end in an increase in jobs. Otherwise, we haven't done our job in economic.
You know, capital investment, is that saying that they're throwing something into their facility that is in St. Charles County? Is that what that means?
Yep.
And jobs must be that's local also. So you need some kind of way to capture that.
That goes back to county. Did we capture that someplace?
It's in the contact. I'll use it. Bottom left. I understand having like an actual radio button that's saying like they're an employee, but I don't see the point in that. Like, cause you're gonna want these as contacts. Like, you're gonna want to put in your 50 contacts into here. Do you have their information, don't you?
I think
onto your
idea,
digits, or?
I think the idea that these employee table is that's gonna be the information for design.
Okay.
Okay, well, that's fine, but I don't wanna say, like, you have either pass them actually, that's very good.
It's, maybe we're asking the same thing, so are you saying that this table, I wanna make sure you agree with this, to this table right here, that's an internal table?
I will say it would be.
Cause if it is, to me, it doesn't belong in this database.
Yeah, that's why we're.
It belongs in a separate database, and it should not be linked to.
Yeah.
Possibly at least, and not that you couldn't, you still could link to it, but if the idea here is, if that's gonna be a historical table, alright, that it's just gonna have all the different employees in there, I don't see where that belongs in here. Now, that said, you know, one thing you talked about before, you may want in here someplace that entered by type of thing, but that to me is not what this is. This is a listing of, like you said, if you've got 15 employees right now, that's what that is. That's what I'm seeing.
And I don't see that as something that you need in database per se.
That, yeah, it seems external to what everything else you're doing.
Unless you're adding each one of the employees as a contact, which that's what I thought you were gonna be doing anyways, I don't see why you need employee first name, last name, and you can just pull up the first name or that contact, this person, put it in. Or whatever.
That's the company you're gonna put through work or.
Yeah, cause you can just have an entered by tab, and then you just scroll that down and there's your.
But we still need to have them in as contact.
Yeah, that's
what I'm saying, yeah, so like, you could, so, what we talked about before, having the 15 names where it has everything filled out.
Right.
You were saying like an Excel thing.
Right.
I thought those, what I, from what I understood, is those we put in as contacts, and then have it be their company be SEC, EDC, or whatever it is.
Right.
So then, I don't see, that's what I'm saying, I don't see the point of having an employee table that has first name, last name, when they're gonna have first name, last name, and contact, I feel like that's redundant, and then have a username and password, if that's supposed to be linked as the login information, I don't see why that needs to be in this database, let alone in the interface, because you're not gonna be entering in your username and password in there, or be showing it at all, so I don't know why we need this, one of that. Or is there a way to, like, I don't know if this is supposed to be like something that we're storing those for their actual, like, the login itself, but I don't think that should be in this table for just contacts in general.
And the way I'm looking at it, maybe, again, maybe we're saying the same thing, that table is internal to your organization.
Mm-hmm.
Every other table is external to your organization. That I can see, or more, at least most every other one. So for that reason, your point's well taken, that it seems like it should be in a separate database. Not that you couldn't necessarily, you can link two different databases together, you can do that. Rather than just putting the table name, you put the name of the database dot the name of the table. So you could do that if you had to. Well, no, I'm saying if you put it in another database. The other thing that does is, you know, and again, you'd have to talk to your guy, but as far as being able to give different types of security to different databases, that one could be very limited then. You know,
otherwise it's just putting every person as a contact itself.
You'd still want to be putting in usernames and passwords. You can encrypt those when you put them into a table.
Yeah, nobody
but,
else is going to have access.
Right, but there's, why would anybody else have to see that?
Right.
I guess is the bottom line.
So you can, you don't have to put username and password in actual, like, when you're entering in a record, because you won't need to do that, because even if it's an employee, there's no reason to put username and password in there when you can have your own, like, I mean, if you're looking up a record, let's say, you don't want to have username and password in there. That's just a security risk in general.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not showing it, you're just entering it in there, then what's the point of having it in there? It's just more of another, it's like a liability almost. Because you don't need the information if you're not going to be using it for anything. Unless you're using it for the login itself, which I almost think that would be dumb to connect that to connect. Or the contact itself.
And what do you think? What do you think about that, Ethan?
I mean, all this way, but I think the table.
No, I didn't say. What I said is you may have to make another database if they want that information, and just put that one table in there. Yeah, I agree.
I just didn't know if it was why it was in there.
I think they were having a long talk because they were just trying to figure out. Sounds like the relationship.
Yeah.
That's all.
Okay. So here's the idea that is behind that table. The employee first name, last name, those are the 15 employees that work at the union. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And their ID is linked back to the person for the enterprise.
Mm-hmm.
Username and password is in there for associating when they're typing in their login, you look back at the employees and their IDs to check against that for the username and password. That's almost my idea, or my problem.
I don't know that. I have to. There comes a point when you have to trust people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I'm going to put something in as Debbie Wisman, and I'm going to mess it up just because, I get what you're saying, but I also go back to, this is a national security.
And the other thing, too, is, as far as, like, the entered by, if you do put it into a separate database, you're still going to have that employee ID, right? Then all you have to do is just you can take that and you could link that, and then for the entered by you just have a drop down with their names.
Well, isn't it automatically gonna populate? Like, if I'm signed in as Christine Lisa,
that's what I was just gonna say. Why do we need the
couldn't it just automatically populate them?
If we're gonna do it that way, then why would we need a drop down? If you log in, then why would you need a drop down for the NFL?
Then it's automatic.
It would just
there.
Put in who's there. That's something that, that's another thing though, is if we're not doing that though, we won't be able to implement that because we wouldn't have that done before.
Right, that would be for your security person.
That's fine.
Right. But I wouldn't even think that would be that big a thing because
right.
You can put locks on tables
yeah.
and, if you said, hey, and you can put different views of the data on tables, and you said, hey, other than Christine and X and Y, nobody else can have insert capability or update or delete capability.
I
think Ethan wants to be done with this.
Done.
No. I mean done with talking about this, what we're talking about right now. He wants to go on.
I can tell you that you can go ahead and create this. I think you can create this is the question that I have for this. This can be created. That can be created. Create. Plus with the addition. Create them. I think that the last tables that you need to create is this one and that one. Dang it!
It doesn't matter.
No. What I'm saying is, somehow.
Maybe it adds like this stuff in. Literally.
Okay. Right.
So
I guess I'm still. My big thing is this relationship.
Yeah.
And this is it, and that's why I'm.
I'll explain that. In your main, you see when go to the list of
there was a separate tag for financing, which just had the fund of
Brian.
And that was separate from the so I think that's what the idea of those are two separate tables.
I believe. And then as we're going through this and refining it, it just kind of becomes a desk government stuff. But that's more from what was I thinking in the beginning, other than here's really how we're set up.
Oh, you want? Yeah.
But I'm looking at it from a database perspective, so on. Like 504 and SEDs are under business development in their own state. They're under business development. It's just one aspect of it, right? And all of us are judged off of what we're doing, but wanna see an increase in setbacks, you don't wanna see an increase in jobs, otherwise, you may, you're not gonna need more development. So why is that not being captured? Not that that's your fault, that's our fault as an organization for having not recognized that.
Tiffany has asked if we could take 10, so.
Oh, take it.
Let's just start back up, he'll be in here just a minute, so.
Oh.
Evan, he'll be in here, I'm sure, momentarily. So do you now have the information that you need as far as?
Yeah, if you wanna do that now.
Do you have any questions on what certain kind of fields should be?
No.
Data types or anything?
We've been going over that, I just came up with some data types, I'm not, I'm not sure, I know we're gonna have to.
Well, I mean, you do that, run it by Ivy and run it by Tiffany, make sure you guys all agree on everything, so. But I mean, you know how to create schemas now, we've done that in SQL Server, right?
Right.
And I'd be more than happy to work with you on that, but you should be able to come in there and create the database and then create the schema and not worrying about the records right now. And if nothing else, if. You've got all those? Okay.
Yeah, I gave it.
I have that?
It's in the video file.
Okay.
It's a blank, word.
Okay, alright, yeah, okay.
Just a data, but then, yeah, but it is having like that, now that I've got alterations.
Yeah, well, after you do alterations, then why don't you send it to me one more time? I will take it, do screenshots of each table and then send them to you and make sure that, you know, that, you know, that there's a good correlation between what your thought is and what your thought is.
I've been making.
You've been making updates, okay, okay.
And I've used that.
Okay.
I did both at the same time, so. If you get a visual for it and then.
And I mean, even if she can't get that data right away, we could always throw in 10 dummy records where we put in all of us.
So.
You know, and her, you know, for example, just as an example, we could put 10 records in there so you can start looking at it and seeing how stuff works.
It can be, they don't need to put them in, it doesn't matter, I think it's like a copy of the database and just do whatever it wants to do.
But what I'm saying is it would be nice to do that.
Yeah.
And put in 10 records, give it to Evan and Brady and have them start to populate that stuff and then actually see what it looks like when it all starts coming together. And then you start to see if there's holes anyplace, if there's something that she, oh, I didn't tell you this, well, then that's the time to find out about it before you really start to populate the database.
So I have a 5-hour drive to Chicago tonight after I drove to and from Bloomington normal yesterday. Yeah, let me tell you.
And there's nothing like driving into Chicago on a Friday night.
Nothing. Nothing.
No, I've done it. I've done it.
So.
Not from here, but from.
My point is, other than the fact that a dog is gonna think that she needs to be on my lap, I can create this spreadsheet tonight on my way. What I need to know is, how do you want me to create? So, and what I mean by that is. We need to create the spreadsheet.
It might be better to have, like you said, make your alterations, send it to me, I can send you screenshots. We can throw in 10, 12, whatever records and say, this is what we're assuming and then have you look at it. Because that's not a big investiture of time or effort, it really is not. But, no, that really.
He's saying like he just, like we won't see like how you're reading it, you know, because how it was used for.
Right.
He's being real, what he needs.
And then he can check the search feature, you guys can add the create button and we can try to put in, you know, maybe you put in all the record, you put in 10 records and then you add two more using the create to see how that works.
Right, I mean, you're already imagining how it's gonna read anyway, just gonna go over with what we're talking about, you know that this is gonna change the option source and then. But just to add something, we're just gonna have some things that we're gonna have some new to they go in and say the grade review.
I put each one of your names in there.
Yeah.
You know, with Rankin's information.
Yeah.
And, you know, let's do that, and then we'll delete you out of the comments, I won't send you anything.
No, but you, we could do that, and then like for some of the other stuff, like industry, you can put in a different industry for everybody. You can do things, you know, again, yeah, put something in there, whether it's Rankin or something else, that just magically puts that in there. You know.
We could copy, we can really make copies of others and make a mock dummy one.
Yeah, I've been changing iterations too.
No, but. And guess what? Yeah, and it's going to get even better because what we're going to start doing starting next week is you're going to learn Git if you don't know it already. I've been teaching it for myself. So.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
But you can take the whole project and put it out there to Git, and it'll at one time it'll save every file. And then every single time you make any changes, all you have to basically do is stage the files that have changed. And boom, it'll always be up to date. And you can backtrack it to any iteration that you've had. So.
Yeah. Okay. I've just been doing every time I do it, basically make a major change, I'll just edit, save items, and then just increment the
My
nephew's
part of it. But I have to go in the house with my brother. So I will say it's pleasure. I love my brother. And actually, you share the birthday with my niece today. So my niece's birthday is today. My stepson's birthday is tomorrow. My former stepson's birthday is tomorrow, and my nephew's birthday is on Sunday. It's just an October festive kind of thing. You should pick something. All right.
Is it
so, yeah, and again, it's more on me than it is you, but the relationship
oh, yeah,
will just go ahead and keep right now. I don't know. This is me. But
some of those things don't necessarily have to be carried as completely different.
Sure.
But just to look at it and have those things, like, I don't know. They're just wrong in having it. Like, just if they look organized, you can get it.
Well, and I guess this is the view from behind the curtain, right? You know,
yeah.
Pay no attention to what I have behind the curtain because the interface of it doesn't look like this. Nobody sees it. I guess in my own head, where I'm at is, well, this to me is a problem on my part, not yours, and not on the woman's. Mine is, why do I have these separated when they're actually the same thing? And they're counted twice.
Okay,
so do you see what I'm saying? If you go back to this.
And then, like we said, the IDA bind will be.
The IDA bind is right. But do you see by resources provided?
Yes.
Still finance. The IDA is a financing mechanism. The 504 loan is an IDA, is a SBA financing. We're talking the same language, and yet we've separated them, and that doesn't make any sense. Again, I'm thinking organizationally.
Right. Well, if I didn't, yeah.
Hmm. Wow.
Yeah, but that's like. There will be options for your finance and information as 504 SBC.
And yet I don't think there needs to
don't think so?
So follow me on that.
If it doesn't, then the resource provided.
If the resource provided needs to be filled out, and it needs to be, this needs to go away, I would change this up.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and keep that one. We'll keep that one. Keep that one. Eliminate that. Project facilitation. SCDC is right here. We already have it.
Yeah.
Financing information, we break down to SBA 504 loan. IDA bond.
Then remember we still have the miscellaneous field here, you know, that we did. So just in case, well, not even just in case, when something's different, you know.
Because I don't know.
You know, at least have the option to handle that with miscellaneous option.
I don't think I need to turn it on.
Turns on.
On the IDA box. You go back to that.
You don't need the turn?
I don't see why I care about the turn. They're already doing all of their IDA. All IDA and all 504 loans go through the financing department of the EDC. They have to have a separate, a whole separate thing.
Right, that's the government.
But see, SBDC is counted twice. So you have them under resources provided, and then you have them up here. And if we're taking this,
okay.
So I think the only reason why this was separated was because
that's all that I knew about it. That's the difference. Is that
it's me.
Well, you can't do anything but that. You know, we're talking once a week here, and we're just going off the best we can.
Can you flip back from the menu?
Right. So, basically, when I still play out the financing data, it's just going to go away and then it'll just be the resources.
Exactly.
So,
because I'm still going to be able to search in my query, if I provided a resource,
yes.
I'm still going to be able to figure out if it was a 504 or an IDA.
And by the, yeah.
Well, hot diggity dog.
Can I ask a question about that too? Because I just, for my own
there's a lot of things
knowledge, what is that? What is impact right there?
All right, so go back to the other one. So impact, so this is what I was saying, right? So what is impact? Impact is
capital
the
investment.
Capital investment.
Right. I understand. What I'm asking is, right now, what is that doing? Anything?
Oh no, that's how I track. That's how we track. So go back to the other one.
What kind of values are in there right now?
The values that are in here are these.
That's,
so this was a drop down. These were all drop down that
so
I
that's
had
these.
Created.
Okay, and I okay, all right. I,
and so the impact was.
Sorry.
I think this is the most that we've ever gone through. That's actually making me work for my money today. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Okay. When I created these drop down boxes, do you have? No, you don't have. I have a spreadsheet that I have to. And this is me, right? But it's all of us. Okay. So each one of us, data without being able to compile it is useless, right? So each one of us in our department has a spreadsheet that each one of us has to fill out. I just had to fill mine out, right? So the projects that I've been working on, the companies that I'm resourcing, all of that. But none of that means anything in terms of my yearly goal until that converts to an impact. So that we can go back and tell our funders why it is that they're giving us money, all right? So, an incentive proposal goes to receive state and local incentives. Once this takes place, I get an Attagirl.
I guess.
So you're asking why?
No, okay. I understand everything that you're saying in here. I understand what this means.
Okay.
My question is this title, for what's in here, is that title maybe misnamed?
Yeah.
And because that is not impact. Those are examples, but impact sounds to me like it should be two checkboxes that says either capital investment or it says jobs.
Yeah.
And then maybe you'd base something off of that, you know, a financial amount or a number of jobs. That's impact. But what you're saying right there, to me, that's why I was asking, because it looks so generic in nature that I don't know how you can be measured on that.
Ta-da!
Yeah. Okay, that's
all. Welcome to my world. This has been a labor of absolute just burdensome yuck for a year and a half. But we use the term impact because we want to feel good about the stuff that we're doing in economic development, right? So if I have done a project facilitation that then got us to opening a new facility in the area, then it's a check mark of we have done our job in economic development. If I give somebody an introduction and it doesn't mean anything, it doesn't impact capital investment or jobs, then it was just an introduction. So that's the reason why we've always looked at what resources are we providing and what by doing those resources, what is the end result? And our end result is,
and those are right. I'm
and
say, right
really
now,
it.
It's not being quantified.
So even in the 504 loan program, right? So they're going to have to get money. And the 504 loan program states that this company has to increase their jobs by X, Y numbers over the course of that loan.
And
so,
then it's your responsibility to call them to find out whether or not that's exactly happening.
Yep. Right. So, but, going back to impact, right, I don't care what happens 3 years from now. I care about the fact that they got a loan for that amount, which is going to increase jobs by that amount. That's all this is. Holy mackerel. You guys are fantastic. You have no idea how fantastic you are at this moment. Seriously. You have solved like all of my major problems in the world. Thank you. Thank you very much. That's what that means. If this happens, but none of this happens here, it doesn't matter how this happens. If that doesn't happen, then there was no quantifiable activity that we did.
And that's what I was looking at, because it's like I was reading the impact. You have increase of jobs, workforce. Well, is that that's a goal, I would take it, right? But and that's something that should be happening. Okay, something in there should be happening. But
right.
Unless that is being quantified, you have no idea.
Yep.
And you might, it sounds to me like one of the things you want to do is you're putting out a lot of money to a lot of these people, and if they're going to come back and want money later, they have to prove that when you gave them money the first time, you got something back for it. Or I shouldn't say that. St. Charles County got something back for what they put out. And it sounds like now there's not a way to do that. Unless you're going in there and manually, and not only that, well, I guess you're counting on them to be honest with you.
Well, yeah, but that's irrelevant to this database, right? So I've been trying to measure a whole bunch of stuff when in fact, it still comes down to two things. Are we getting capital investment and are we having an increase? Yes. If the answer to those are yes, then those have to be, I should be able to research or query that and give a report and say, my activities have equaled up to this much in capital investment and this much in jobs. Moment of exaltation, does this help you?
Well, the bottom line is, does it help you? Because if they can look at it and talk about it and see what they think should, you know, how that should be updated, but then they'll show it to you. And again, this is the time to go and ferret that stuff out before you actually put in real data and have you say, yeah, that's something, you're right, that's something I really needed, I'm not capturing it now, or yeah, you did your partway there, but I also need, then they add that. Like, as Ethan said, that's adding a field.
Okay.
Right now, that's not a big...
Did you get that?
Oh.
Sorry, did you get it? Because there's only one other relationship that I need to make sure is in here somehow. And that is...
You want to go back? Okay.
Go back. So, and I'm like, my table's people, okay? If I say this is a project facilitation, I need to know... where it came from, and whether or not it got approved. With the goal still being CapEx and jobs. But this is relationship to that, which is relationship to that.
It almost sounds like there's enough stuff in here that could be almost two or three tables.
I didn't know. I'm just looking at my own table going.
You know, this had really come from that nobody thought that I was doing anything because this hadn't happened, but I didn't know any company and I needed to start somewhere. I'm beyond this and going to that. The next person that comes into business development, well, good luck to them. They can figure out. Holy mackerel! You guys are fantastic. You didn't even know, did you? Come on, you knew. You have no idea. You've solved a problem. You gave me a you helped me walk through a solution that I didn't even think about. All right. So rather than wasting the rest of your day, what else? And I hope that
terms. Spell expenditure.
ITUR.
Can you print the, never mind.
If you want me to, I can.
No, I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
I don't want that stuff associated with the new stuff, I think it has to be associated with those people going to be, like I've been doing.
I've got my, if it helps, I do have, we're gonna do it next week in class, but I'm also doing them separately, so I already have three lectures out there on how to use it. You wanna take a look at. But they're just, and I might do more this weekend, I don't.
Okay.
I guess cool. I just didn't know how to use it really, and I tried it out, so.
Can we go back to the beginning? Other than that, anything else? It's just been this, but that's been based off of.
Yeah.
Problems. Yeah. My own internal stuff, like.
Yeah.
Alright, what else do you guys need for me other than just shut up and go home?
In Chicago.
My mother is going with me, so I have to have my dog on my lap, cause my mother hates dogs. So when y'all are sitting at home all spread out with that Coke in your hand, popcorn, we have to go like this, 20-pound dog. But you're gonna send me a spreadsheet?
Whenever I get done with that one, I'm gonna.
I don't think I need an update of the schema. I think we've already talked that to death. I need to have the spreadsheet so I can give you the EDC employee.
Right, until this is changed, there's no need for it right now. So, I mean, because it is going to change, you know, it's a little. You won't know how to put it in necessarily or.
Am I coming back next Friday? Even if you give it to me on Thursday, I can do a quick data entry of 15 names and all the information.
No, it sounds like you've already got most of that stuff, right? You know what I mean? The
work.
And the only change was on me.
What I'm saying is there's no point in starting to put something in whenever this is about to change.
Yes, I agree with that.
And that's why
I agree with
it.
No, I agree with that too. But the other thing too is, I mean, worst case scenario, what we could do is if you update all the schema, okay, and just give me the table, the information she needs to enter for those employees, I can send that to her. Even if you throw it into Access, I can convert it on there for that.
Okay.
That's not a problem. And then you'll have something you can put into yours.
Friday.
Yeah.
Next Monday.
Oh yeah, don't not this weekend, yeah.
You don't wanna worry about it this weekend?
No. But the earlier next week we can get done, the better, because my wife's coming down either Wednesday or Thursday. We have, I don't know if I, well, the big news is we now have people who wanna buy ours in Illinois. The bad news is they have to sell theirs.
Oh no.
Yeah. So, yeah, so they just dropped their price hoping they'll sell it. They don't have anybody who wants to buy theirs right now. So they just dropped theirs $5,000 because they're moving up.
Yep.
They've got ours is a two-story, four bedroom, 2.5 baths. They have, I think, a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, and they've got enough kids where they want to upgrade. So. I don't have one in Wisconsin. Wow, I was going to say, unless you know something, I don't know.
I thought she was still in Illinois.
No, she's in Illinois. She's right on the Wisconsin border. But there's a chance that for 1 or 2 months I could have 2 houses and an apartment. I don't want that either. But we only owe, I think, $5,000 on our house in Illinois. And then it's paid off. So, and if I need to, I can pay that right now. And then my daughter wants $2,000 as a down payment for her wedding.
No idea. That was very exciting. Well, send it to me. I mean, send it to me in whatever format. And then I'll go ahead and get it entered. And I'm assuming that's Friday. Is that right? You're all so happy.
Well, like I said, it would be nice to have something and then being able to actually bring that up.
Well.
And, you know, maybe tightening up the Amin landing page, and then putting the link in there to the search, and then starting to put some of that, you know, the words can all start to come together, hopefully.
Oh, I think so. No, what I mean is that you guys will be gracing me with your presence next week.
That's a regular Friday thing.
And everybody looks so happy about it too. Did you notice? They're like, oh my gosh.
I don't mind. I'm gonna be drunk.
I get a beer.
Yeah.